This week, I'm talking about astronauts. Many of us are already familiar with moonwalker Buzz Aldrin or Chris Hadfield, who famously sang David Bowie's Space Oddity aboard the International Space Station. But I want to talk with you about five astronauts and cosmonauts that I think are really, really awesome and should be on your radar if they aren't already. First up is Anousheh Ansari. Anousheh is the very first privately funded woman to ever be in space. So she funded herself to go into space, which is really, really cool. She also is the very first Iranian in space. She grew up in Iran dreaming of the stars and moved to the US as a teenager. Personally, Anousheh's story brings me a lot of joy. My grandfather is Iranian, and I actually had the chance to visit Iran last year, which was incredible. But Anousheh is so awesome because before she even was able to send herself into space, she was actively making space exploration more accessible for others. She famously sponsored the Ansari X Prize. The winner of the Ansari X Prize was the foundation for the company Virgin Galactic, which is now trying to send humans into suborbital space. I got the incredible chance to interview Anousheh Ansari for my book, What's It Like in Space? And we got to talk about a lot of things about her experience in space and what it was like to be someone who had dreamed of being in space her entire life and what it was like when she finally got there. One of the things she told me was that when she finally got to space, she didn't sleep at all. She couldn't possibly bring herself to sleep because she wanted to spend every waking moment looking out the window at the Earth and the stars and soaking it all in. Which is fine, of course, except for the fact that when they were preparing for re-entry and returning to Earth, she couldn't keep her eyes open at all. She kept falling asleep to the point that her crew members were worried that she was ill or sick or something was terribly wrong. She finally had to explain to them about how she had barely slept at all the entire week she was in space because she wanted to spend every moment looking out the window. The next awesome astronaut is Leland Melvin. And Leland is really cool because he's the only person to have been drafted into the NFL and into NASA's astronaut program. But the road that he took to become an astronaut was far from easy. After being drafted into the NFL, Leland suffered two major injuries, which ended his football career. So he instead then applied to NASA's astronaut program and eventually got in. But there again, he suffered an injury, this time actually an injury that made him deaf, which grounded him from spaceflight. Fortunately, after surgery and putting in a lot of work, Leland was able to regain partial hearing and eventually was allowed to fly in space. You might recognize Leland from a photo of his that went viral, his official astronaut photo that features him and his two dogs. It turns out he actually had to sneak in his two dogs into NASA to get them into that photo, but we're all thankful that he did. Leland not only considers himself an athlete and an astronaut, but also an engineer, a scientist, a photographer, and a musician. All of which feed into his passion and what he works on nowadays, which is trying to encourage education that combines both science, technology, and art. Next up is Jose Hernandez, and Jose Hernandez is the son of migrant farm workers. He grew up dreaming of space as well. Specifically, he watched Apollo 17 land on the moon when he was 10, which really inspired him. But it wasn't until he was in high school that that dream really felt like it was a possibility when he heard about Franklin Chang Diaz, one of the very first Latin Americans in space. What's amazing about Jose's story is that he actually applied to NASA's astronaut program a whopping 11 times. He got 11 rejections before he actually got accepted on the 12th time. The average astronaut who gets accepted eventually into NASA's program might only get rejected two or so times. So the fact that Jose really persisted to make his dream a reality is absolutely incredible. He says that after each rejection that he got from NASA, he would study the biographies of the people who did get accepted and then really try and learn the things that those people learned. So if there were astronauts getting accepted who were pilots, he learned how to pilot, how to scuba dive, he learned how to speak Russian, everything. He really modeled himself after the astronauts that were getting picked and was able to persist and eventually get accepted into NASA's astronaut program. Jose continues to do awesome things. He ran for Congress in 2012, and he's considering running again maybe in the future. Another amazing astronaut is Mae Jemison, and Mae became the very first African-American woman in space in 1992. Growing up, Mae always assumed that she would one day go to space. She considers Lieutenant Uhura from Star Trek to be one of her biggest inspirations, to the point that many years later, when Mae finally actually got into outer space, she would begin each of her shifts with saying, "Hailing frequencies open," Lieutenant Uhura's famous line. Another cool thing Mae did with her time in space is she actually brought a lot of art objects with her from West African countries to symbolize how space exploration really belongs to all nations. Prior to becoming an astronaut, Mae went to Stanford at the age of 16. She also served in the Peace Corps, providing medical care for people. In addition to being an astronaut, Mae is a doctor, an art collector, and a dancer, which is pretty cool. Finally, I want to talk to you about cosmonaut Valentina Tereshkova. Valentina became the very first woman ever in space at the age of 26 in 1963. Growing up, Valentina became interested in parachute jumping, and she did a lot of parachute jumping. And after Yuri Gagarin's historic very first spaceflight of any human in history, she volunteered to become a cosmonaut. What's really fascinating about Valentina's story is that her mission was classified to the point that she didn't tell her family about it. She told her family that she was going to a parachuting competition on the same day she was set to go into space. It was only later that day that when she was already in space, her mother heard about her actually being in outer space through hearing about it on the radio. When Valentina went into space, she orbited the Earth 48 times, meaning that she spent more time in space than all US astronauts combined at that time. After going into space, Valentina continues to do awesome work. She got her doctorate, served in the Russian parliament, received an award from the United Nations, but she always spoke fondly about her time in space and always wanted to return. Unfortunately, she didn't get that opportunity. So I hope you enjoyed learning about those five astronauts and cosmonauts. I think they're incredibly awesome, but please in the comments, tell me any astronauts or cosmonauts or taikonauts or anyone that's been into space that you think is awesome that maybe I didn't talk about today. That's it for me this week, space friends. Remember to subscribe on YouTube and join Patreon, where you can get sneak peeks of my work, signed copies of my book, and a lot of other stuff. Also, be sure to check out the YouTube description this week, as I will link to a lot of the books that the astronauts I spoke about have written.